A long time ago, I asked myself a question, and the question was, who am I? Where am I from? Where am I going? What is it that I'm meant to do? For me, those questions have remained my whole life. But I know this. I spent a lot of my life allowing other people's opinions and fears and self-doubts and biases influence how I feel about myself. You see, I believe that you and I were put here for reasons greater than we could ever understand. And that who we are is not what we do or where we work, the size of our bank account, the type of car we drive, the size of our house. I believe it's about the people we love, the people we give our heart to, the people we surround ourselves with. Because sometimes I don't believe in myself. Sometimes the person I want to be and the person I am seems so very far away. It's like looking at the moon, and it's this beautiful, shining, clear image, but it seems so far away. So now, with our eyes on the moon, let's make our way towards the person we are, towards the person we may have been too frightened to be. All around us are people who are ready to tell us the truth of our lives, to define us, to judge us, to limit us. And so many times in my life, I've allowed those voices to drown out my own. When I think of the moon, I think of Runa. And in the Māori tradition, Runa was taken up by the moon to become the tide controller, to become the controller of destinies. And it started out as an angry act. She swore at the moon. Upokokohua, boiled head. Of course, the moon being the moon took exception to that and drew her up. Runa was not content to stay a prisoner. She became the controller of tides, the master of her destiny. And for me, sometimes I need to remember that. Like Runa, I've done things that I'm not proud of. I've said things in anger and in haste, and things that I really didn't mean. I have been harmed and I have caused harm. But like Runa, you and me, we don't have to be defined by those things, by the short-sightedness of those who hold us back and tell us we can't, and we shouldn't, and we won't. So in this contemplation, I want you to see the moon as clearly as you see yourself. On a beautiful clear night. And with every breath, and with every decision, and every mistake, we are learning, growing stronger, and walking towards our authentic selves. It's really up to you and me. Do we allow the fear, jealousy, small-mindedness, and bigotry of others? So much room in our lives that we forget who we are and where we belong. When you get into the situation, I want to encourage you to sit quietly and breathe. And in your mind, in your heart, in your soul, remember who it is that you really are. Not through the lens of others, not through the lens of that voice inside ourselves that says, I can't continue. I want to give up. I'm not good enough. I'm not worthy. I want you to silence that voice. Silence it and realize that it's there. But breathe into it anyway. Breathe into your authentic self. Deep breathing. Focusing. Turning your face towards the moon. Growing your wings. Getting in your plane and your rocket ship. Hopping in a cannon. Whatever it takes to move towards who you truly are. Because who you truly are, who I truly am, who we truly are, is more than enough. It's worthy of love. It's worthy of respect. It's worthy of nurturing. It's strong and disciplined. And can give love and can pay respect and create things that only we were put here to create. If you're in a place where you believe you cannot go on, and that enough is enough, I want you to look at the moon. Feel the beauty. Feel the mana, the integrity, and the eternal nature of the moon. Brothers and sisters, let's walk towards that together, because you are more than worthy. I trust me. I trust you. I trust us.